How are you doing, 254? Why don't you go ahead and let us know? You know what time it is.
It's time for Sports Central, that show that guarantees you your weekly fix of sports action. We're your hosts, Mike Mondo.
And I'm your lady in red, Wanjira Longauer. Keep it locked because we got a sick show coming up for you, like always.
Absolutely. Well, we've got the business end of the 2016-2017 Kenya Cup action all lined up for the show. Find out about that mouth-watering rugby action.
And you gotta find out what happened when we went to the Coliseum gym and learned about Muay Thai, of all things.
I love watu wa Machakos County to kona nyinyi as we get to kick it with Syokimau FC.
And it gets better and better, but primero, or first.
The Kenya Rugby Union, in conjunction with the headline sponsor SportPesa, unveiled the new playing kit for national teams. The kits come just in time as the Kenya Sevens and Lionesses look to impress in Hong Kong.
One of the things we're doing this afternoon is to launch a new kit for the teams, the Kenya new outfit that we're going to use, not just on the Sevens series, but throughout the squads that we have.
The kit that we're launching today is an embodiment of African culture, the rich Kenyan colors in the flag, and the true spirit of a warrior. We'd like you to invite you to help us as we savor the glory of the game as we move on, and also to appreciate the kit that we are launching today. SportPesa is still committed in every endeavor, every part of the game that we are engaged in. We are sponsoring and partnering with different sports everywhere. For rugby has been a special element of the sporting world for us because of obvious reason, because the game is really growing at an immense proportion, and we'd like all of you to be part of that growth.
We are saying that we are made of winners, and it's glad for us to partner with rugby itself as a growing sport and to reiterate our commitment in supporting sport and rugby in particular.
And while the guys gear up for the World Rugby Series, make sure you let us know what you think of this jersey, as well as any messages you may have for the team. Use the hashtag SportsCentralKE and roar behind them.
Still on some more rugby action, epic clashes went down as teams were battling it out in order to find out who's going to face off against KCB and Homeboys in the semi-final of the 2016-2017 Kenya Cup.
As a matter of fact, I got the whole scoop for you, or at least half of it. The SportPesa Queens actually tried to edge out Mwamba RFC.
The Cabras Sugar were trying to beat Impala in their bid to defend their title as the Kenya Cup holders.
With the limited slots for the Kenya Cup locked down, KCB and Homeboys had already clinched two of the semi-final spots, leaving the SportPesa Queens, Cabras, Impala and Mwamba to battle it out for the rest. At the Impala grounds, Impala looked to make good against a Cabras side that had been a difficult nut to crack if their previous encounters was anything to go by. A great start would see the Saracens touching down the first try of the match, much to the excitement of the home fans. However, incredibly executed mauls would ensure that the Sugarmen remain firmly in control of the game and eventually secure a semi-final spot against the Homeboys with a final score of 21-18.
Difficult game because Impala at home, and we've won. I think we've beaten them 5 times, so it was not going to be an easy game. So we worked hard, we watched their games, we had to know where how they play, and their strong points, their weak points. We worked on them, and I think we played according to plan, and we won.
We started really, really well, and whenever we moved the ball, there was progress, but somehow we didn't defend them all reasonably well, and 2 tries came out of that. We also lost a bit of the discipline. And so, you know, second half was basically about penalties for Cabras. But at the end of the day, you know, this is a competition and somebody wins and the other doesn't. We came very interested in playing, and you can see we played right up to the end. And really, that's if you are to lose, that's the only way you do.
Focus now shifts to the semi-finals as KCB looks to edge out the Sportpesa Queens at the Lions' Den, while Cabras looks to eliminate the Homeboys at Jamhuri Showgrounds to determine which will be the only 2 teams left standing.
It has never been an easy game playing Homeboys. Homeboys is a good side. They plan well, they play well, and they are tactically well off. So I think we have a week to work on everything that will make us win. Anything that will bring us a win, we'll work on it.
Sports Central takes a break. We'll be right back.
Welcome back. And just in case you are joining us, you're watching Sports Central. This is the show that guarantees your weekly fix of sports action.
Muay Thai, a popular combat sport from Thailand, is mostly a combination of stand-up and clinching techniques. Now, it hit international popularity by the 20th century when people basically realized they could break a lot of bones with this sport over almost all others.
And that is why Sports Central had to visit the Coliseum Gym, where we got to hang out with 2 trainers. And as it turns out, there's actually more reason why you should learn Muay Thai. Take a look.
Well, my name is Jeff Njuguna. I'm a personal trainer at the Coliseum right here in Nairobi. My interest in martial arts started many years ago. Ever since I was a kid, I always wanted to learn martial art. And along the way, I developed a specific interest for Muay Thai after watching a movie called Ong Bak. It's also referred to as the art of eight limbs, because in Muay Thai you have eight striking points. You have the fists, you have the elbows, you have the knees, and you have the shins. Yeah, when you kick in Muay Thai, you don't kick with the foot, you kick with the shin. So those are basically your eight different striking points. Yeah, so I've been doing it for about 10 years now.
I came to the owner, Andre, and he started training me. So part of my weight loss program was Muay Thai.
Someone who comes in wants to train to be a professional fighter will train different from someone who comes in and just wants to do it for fitness, for example.
As a woman, I did not know how to fight. You know, I'd take something, but I didn't know how to make a fist, I didn't know how to hit someone, and I didn't know where would have what effect. Through Muay Thai, I've learned this is where you hit, this is how you hit. I've learned how strong I am, I've learned how far I should push myself to hurt someone, and what I shouldn't do if I don't want to hurt someone. It's definitely boosted my confidence as a woman.
Wakao is one of the top names in Muay Thai. He's from Thailand. He's actually one of the best fighters from Thailand. He's very famous, very well known. Another really good fighter that you can actually look up on YouTube as well is a guy called Sanchai. Now you see, these are guys who've been in the art for a very long time. They've been fighting since they were young. Best fighter who's come out of this gym is called Douglas. Now, unfortunately, Douglas passed away a couple of years ago. But Douglas, in his day, before he retired, was actually, I believe, the best fighter that's come out of this country. Now, Douglas was a K-1 champion, yeah? He was world number one in K-1 in his weight category, and world number eight. And again, you know, the K-1 tournament brings in the best fighters from all around the world, so that really says something. One of our most recent professional fighters to go out is Samir. Samir is based in Holland. He has a professional fighting contract with a top fighting gym in Holland, where all the best fighters in Holland come from.
And over the past 2.5-3 years is where I've seen an influx. Men and women of any and every demographic. You know, Indian, foreigners, Kenyans, any and everyone.
You don't have to have a certain level of fitness to do Muay Thai, or you don't have to be a certain age to do Muay Thai. I've seen kids start from as young as 4 years old, and we have clients training who are even in the 50s.
If you're looking at doing something different, fun, if you really want to, excuse my French, kick ass, then by all means, give it a try. But only if you're up for the challenge. Don't come here thinking, oh, I'm fit, blah, blah, blah. No, because in this gym, we break people.
How about that, Mike? I thought that was so cool. I mean, physical fitness paired with self-defense, I'm so here for it.
Super, super cool. By the way, after last week's my failed attempt at throwing the javelin, I think this is the sport I should get into, you know? Get my physical on.
I want you to be a lean, mean fighting machine. Are you with it or not?
Yeah, I'm with it. I mean, if Floyd Mayweather's coming out of retirement to fight a UFC fighter, I mean, why not me?
So all he needs is Mike Mondo to
just
flatten him out.
Just a bit of
out,
that huh? Mike Mondo. You know, you never know.
Let me find out you're making that Floyd Mayweather money. Well, at the end of the day, we're here for you. So you see all that social media that's scrolling across the screen. Why don't you let us know about your sport? Why don't you let us know about your team? We are inside that plan.
Absolutely, tuko ndani, ndani kabisa. And of course, one place where we were ndani is Machakos County. We head on down there to kick it with the Syokimau FC. Take a look at this.
My name is Yusuf Mohammed. I'm the coach for Syokimau FC. Syokimau FC started like 4 years ago. These young players used to play for fun. Basically, I came up with an idea and I brought this team together. We joined the FKF League, that's from the sub-county level. They happened to be the best team. In that whole league, they were only beaten by one team, and they became unbeaten ever since.
Hizo competitions za kitambo zimekuwa hard. Najua si ni upcoming team. Tumepata ma team zilikuwa hiyo league. So kuanza na kupanda juu hadi number 1 ilikuwa ngumu sana. Alafu hatuna ma sponsor. Ilikuwa shida mbaya. Naenda ma game, hakuna transport. Na baki tu tumechip in kwa mfuko zetu na ma wishes, tunaenda game. Tunajibamba, tunarudi mtaani kama tumeshinda. Games zenye zina stand out ni moja ya Syokimau FC na Devki. By the end ya Ando alitop. Ando alikuwa number 1, si number 2. Hiyo ndio ilikuwa game ngumu kwa season mzima. Wako top, tuko top. So hiyo game mkiingia mna clash. Ilikaa ni kama clash of the titans. Ilikuwa ngumu sana.
We are now preparing for the Division 2 because last year we did all the hard work. We managed to get a slot. So we are trying to do the preparations for the Division 2. We understand it should start anytime soon. The mood is excellent. We are happy. We are very proud of each other, especially me. I'm proud of my team. My captain is excellent. My goalkeepers, everybody's on top of their game. And every time we have a match, they do very good preparation. The psyche is there, and we always get the best results. These guys need a platform to showcase themselves, and we really need that sponsorship because these players, when you give them something to do on the ground, it keeps away the crimes and all the other things that young people do, you know, drugs and all kinds of things. So we are really clearing that out of the picture. So they are very disciplined.
The moment unaingia grao kuja na purpose, si ukama ati unakamka gym na kama kukata weight, pana unakama learn something. Kama ujui touch unakama unafunzwa, kama ujui na kuja unauliza msimu nyana juu una learn. Football ina speak one language, ikuwe ni Mkongo, ikuwe ni Nigeria, umetoka sijui wapi, hii kitu inatuletanga pamoja si wote. So kwenye nasema, ukipata ball ndani, kama we ni fan wa ball, na kama we si fan wa ball, support huyo player.
So we are trying to get fans, we are trying to get sponsorship so that we can carry this dream all the way to the end of the year.
This is Syokimau FC and you're watching Sports Central. Mungu saidie, Mungu saidie, Mungu saidie. Vivo, vivo. Vivo!
Shikot!
Well, once again, we have to wrap it up on Sports Central. Aki Maze, this is just the most painful part when I have to say Kwaheri, but Usijali will be with you very soon. Remember, you can always catch up with our previous episodes on YouTube and also the social.
And speaking of social, Willie Buru did go ahead and say that he loves the way Sports Central guys present sports. Oh, merci beaucoup, mon amour.
Also, Bernadette Kageshu, you're saying you loved our earlier feature on Fatuma Zarika. Thank you for, of course, checking out our previous episodes. Kumbuka, it's all about subscribing. So if you haven't subscribed, go ahead on our YouTube page and subscribe, subscribe, subscribe. Yep. Well, Wanji, we've had some really amazing rally drivers on the show.
Oh, tell me about it.
Yep, really dope drivers. Well, for our internet find this week, we've got one special one. Maybe this is the future talent. You never know. We're going to leave you with that video. But until next time,
keep it Sports Central.
Talented little drivers.